Hi everyone, remember this room? I used to do videos from here all the time across 2020 to 2023, the start of this year, and it's amazing I'm back. And I just thought I'd pop in to say hi, that this pick a card that I'm going to share with you, I pre-recorded it the week before I flew out, and I tried to find the date on the files. I wasn't able to find the date because my camera isn't set up with a date and time thing. So I'm pretty sure I recorded it on the 7th of December, on the Thursday before I flew out. So yeah, I just wanted to say hi and show you this room again. Some of you will remember this room. And I'm back here doing videos, but when it comes to the monthly and things like that, I don't feel inspired to be in this room anymore. Like, you can see I've left it messy. Like, you can see my suitcase there, you can see my stuff on the table there, and I've got like a towel on the, oh, you can't even see the chair. Well, anyway, because I'm not sure how to set this thing up so that you can see the room in the same way, but I'm just not feeling inspired to make videos from here. But I thought I'd just, you know, let you see my room where I do my editing and all that. And I do the readings if you book or any of that. I also thought, because it's pick a card and we like to see objects in pick a card, I thought I would show you my little wombat. He's so cute. Look at that. Isn't he adorable? It's a wombat. And he's not real, but he comes actually from the Netherlands. If you read his tag, he's this little worldwide foundation or whatever that thing is. You know, that organization thing. I don't know. Anyway, apparently it was made in the Netherlands. But he is a wombat and he's really cute. And if you travel with a wombat, I recommend it because they're perfect. You can just kind of put them here and sleep on them, and they're really great on the plane. So you can definitely take a wombat with you on your next flight. But yeah, I just thought I'd pop in, say hi, show you my good old room that I don't think I'm gonna film from. We'll see. I'm feeling very inspired to go outside and film outdoors. So hopefully the future videos I do while I'm down here will be outside. That would be really nice. But I'm gonna leave you to the pick a card now, which I recorded, as I say, in England, but I'm currently in Sydney, Australia. I will be here for another couple more months, and then I'll be back in the old room in England. I'll be back there soon. Hi everyone, welcome back to Vedic Life Coaching. Thank you so much for joining me, and welcome to, now I want to say a timeless pick a card reading, but I also want to say that we're going to take a little look at the year ahead. So what I'll say is that this is a reading for next year, or the space of a year. I mean, you could end up watching this later, but I think the reality is, with my pick a cards, people just watch them in the moment. I don't particularly have people going and watching the old ones, so I will say this is for 2024. Yeah, why not? And if you would like to pick your, now again, what are these that I've got here in front of me? Writing implement of choice. There we go. Because they're not all pens or pencils. We've got a bit of a mixture here. So if you would like to choose group number one, then you'll be choosing this. I'll try and focus it. There we go. I think it's in focus. Is it? Yeah, you'll be choosing the Apple Pencil, this futuristic, lovely white magic wand type of thing, which you could choose. I love this, it's great. Or you could choose this. Now I'll try and focus that if I can. It is a pencil, but is it a pencil or is it
actually a pen, and that is something that you'll find out if you choose it. So there's that, or there is this stunning silver cross pen you could choose. Hang on, let's try and focus that. There we go. So you could choose this object, which is a shiny silver pen. As always, choose your writing implement and I'll see you in your reading. Hi there, group number one. If you chose group number one or this Apple pencil, let's try and focus it. I think it's focused. There we go. Then you are in the right place. Let's talk about the Apple pencil. So what is it? Well, it is very futuristic, and you know, if I try to write on a surface, it won't do anything, okay? But when paired with the right thing, well, yes, it can express a lot of things, you know, and it can communicate. But otherwise, I think left on its own, it can't speak very much. So let's focus that in. So that is kind of interesting, isn't it? It's one of those things that needs, oh, and it doesn't want to focus. It doesn't want to be seen. Come on, focus. Oh, it doesn't matter. We'll leave it. Let's shuffle. Let's see what comes. We're going to shuffle for your year ahead. So, I mean, this is also a future sort of an object, something to do with the future, something to do with technology. The other thing I also thought about the Apple pencil is that because it's technology, I'll shuffle in front of you. Because it's technology, like, yeah, there's not much emotion there. There are lots of connotations with the Apple pencil, you know. Okay, we'll take that one. These are dragon cards, by the way, because next year is the year of the dragon. I still haven't looked up my Chinese year thing. I will. I haven't had the time. I've been busy doing lots of things. All right, let's shuffle and see what comes. So group number one, 2024, what's coming up? What does the year ahead hold for you? Okay, one of these as well. All right, let's see. Well, that one, yeah, wants to be there. We might put that one first, actually, because it is the biggest. Oh, let's not drop all the cards. Okay, and oh yeah, one of these. How are you, group one? I hope you're well, wherever you are. Bit of shuffle on camera. Yep, okay. Oh, there's two. Well, we'll take that one. All right. Let's see what you've got here, group one. So we'll start with this one. Ooh, surrender. Nice. I love the visual here. We've got these cute little kids again. They're so sweet. Oh, look at that one up there. It's like he's on a star, a leaf that looks like a star. Well, they all look like stars. That's a really nice picture. Oh, it's not focusing. There we go. See, and it's surrender, letting go. It's so fun. There's a joy here. There's like, it's fun to let go. It's fun to be free. And it's gentle. It's not scary. You know, it's it's nice. All right. I mean, these kids look like they're having a great time. If we can focus in on their face, if they've even got their little pets in there, let's have a look. Are those kittens? What are they? They look like little kittens. That's so cute. Okay, so that's really nice. It's number seven as well. Your dragon card, ooh, is the air dragon. Okay, what is this all about? Helps you rise above earthly matters. That's fascinating because we've got you in the sky here as well. So air is here twice. Helps you rise above earthly matters, communicate honestly, brings inspiration and hope, see life from a higher perspective. That is wonderful. I love that. That's a great beginning there, group number one. You're up in the sky. Oh, nice. Unexpected visitors. Wow. Okay. That's interesting. We've got a 41 there, and that's a number 5. Who are these unexpected visitors? Well, we might shuffle on that. 10 of Pentacles. Wow, that's great. All right, I like it. Group number 1. 10 of Pentacles. And we've got that tree trunk kind of a thing, but it's like this guy has carved it. You've created it. You've done something here. This is good. Okay. It's interesting, we've got as well, the colors are browns, oranges. So I'm also getting a feel of Jupiter here as well. Jupiter and Saturn. We've got the dark blue here. So this does feel like quite a big, strong year for you. Those are the two biggest planetary energies that we've got. And they're making their presence known. Also, you've got the sky, Saturn, the dark blue Saturn, yeah. But also the brownie orange of Jupiter. Okay, well, let's shuffle on unexpected visitors because I am none the wiser here. Her face, she does look a little bit worried. Oh, I can use the pen. She does look a bit worried here. Both of these are looking in the same direction. All right, let's see if we can figure out who these unexpected visitors are. Okay, we'll shuffle. So unexpected visitors. Shuffle, we'll get one for that. And we'll get one for the Ten of Pentacles as well. So far, so good. The other thing is that you've risen above something, maybe. You've risen above something, you've surrendered, you've let go. I think you've risen above a situation. He's above this as well. So I'm getting a lot of good vibes here. Okay, so unexpected visitors, what is that? Nope, there we go. And we'll take one for this Ten of Pentacles as well. What is it that you've achieved? Oh, that came quickly. All right. So definitely think there's like a progression here. You've possibly achieved something. So unexpected visitors, let's have a look at that first. Yeah, we've got the Five of Swords here. You're in the fives. That's a five there too. Okay. All right. We'll come and deal with that in a moment. And what's this Ten of Pentacles? Wow, Nine of Swords. All right. Okay, let's take a look. Let's take a look. Yeah, you're in the fives here. Yeah, the fives. It's a tricky place to be. I know what that is like. But surrender is really going to help, okay? So as we can see here, unexpected visitors. It's kind of like I get the feeling that there's something that you're not done with. I think 2024 is the year to resolve it, so don't worry. I think that this will be the year. Because very often when challenging or difficult cards come up, they're coming up because it's here for you now to resolve this. So I do think that there's resolution here. And I think you're going to figure something out in quite a significant way. I think this actually belongs here. The Nine of Swords belongs here with this unexpected visitors card. We've got the Five of Swords here. We've got the Nine of Swords here. This combination here, this is difficult. And it does bring stress, difficulty. But your way through, and this is so amazing because I've just finished writing an email to one of you, and I know one of you, that one of you who I'm writing the email to, you may be here listening to this. So what I said in the email was this thing about when you've got these energies going on, the big lesson here can be to learn how to turn the other cheek, right? And that's an old phrase that we have in You know, it's certainly a Western cultural phrase that is there, turn the other cheek. I think it was Jesus that said that, if I've got that right. And it's an important phrase because it's a phrase of don't attack back. And you know, just kind of give them more cheek, if you know what I mean. You know, while one is healing, give them the other one, kind of thing. And if that one needs to heal, well, then yeah, turn the other cheek. I mean, if you look at that concept of cheek, cheek is infinite in spiritual terms. So you can keep giving them that in a way. Yeah. Or if somehow you rise above and you give them cheek as in being cheeky, as in humorous thing, or you show them that you're not bothered by their antics, you know, if you've got this kind of difficulty here going on, Five of Swords, we've got conflict and there's an injustice here, and this kind of injustice can really bring about sleepless nights. So that's understandable. But your way through really is going to be surrender. So this is about letting go. This is about not allowing yourself to be dragged down. You're floating in the sky. You're letting go. You're letting go of the earthly stuff and just realizing, hey, I'm okay. I think this is your year of mastery of that energy. Okay, so we've got here Air Dragon. Let's have a look. Communicate honestly. That's going to be really, really important. And we've got here, it's really interesting that we've got this Apple Pencil here, which is, yeah, as I was saying, like, this object needs to be paired with another object before it can express itself. There is that here with this Apple Pencil. And it's like when you find the iPad, then you can communicate honestly and express and all that kind of thing and be understood. And but you know, if you're writing and there's no ink and it doesn't work, you know, it doesn't work anywhere, right? But then you get that iPad and oh my god, it works. So there's something like that. It's kind of like, it's like, yeah, well, maybe you've got to find the iPad or something along those lines. And there are millions of iPads in the world, you know, millions of Apple Pencils. Like, it's not going to be hard. Let's have a think about this. What else do I want to explore? But see, the Apple Pencil is appropriate here because these people in this situation, they're not going to understand you. You're not a match to these people here. See, you're writing and they're not understanding, the ink isn't coming out, kind of thing. Yeah, it doesn't work. Whereas you pair this with an iPad and yeah, things work again. Interesting. I didn't know this Apple Pencil was going to go in that direction. When I was first thinking about it today, I was thinking about how there's no emotion with an Apple Pencil. There's no, yeah, it's just technology. That was what I was thinking about it. But I didn't realize I was going to bring up all this stuff about, yeah, it pairing with an iPad. The other thing about the Apple Pencil and no emotion is that that could be your way of surrendering, because perhaps, so you getting emotional, maybe someone in your space is manipulating you because they want you to be emotional, right? And that's how they control you, because you do become emotional. So when you surrender by not being emotional and not feeding into their drama, then you are free, okay? And have your emotions, right? I'm not saying don't be emotional, but have them privately. Don't have them in front of these people. It's kind of like you have to gray rock these people or something like that for in order for yourself to be free. Yeah, I think that's true. And I do think next year is going to be the year where you feel a ton of freedom. You know, I think this is going to be some kind of thing of mastery. And you're building. Look, you've materialized the Ten of Pentacles. Okay, you have manifested the dream life. It exists. It's wanting to come through for you. So either some of it has already come through, but there's a lot more of it to come. Okay, and look at how much is due to come in. How much abundance. Look at all these flowers. He's got a, you know, gray beard here, a long gray beard. Okay, look at how long it took him to make that. You know, I mean, yeah, it's like there's a lot of good that is lined up for you. Decades of good, possibly, that is lined up for you, that is wanting to come in. It's just that there, I think, yeah, next year there might be a couple of little hurdles here and there, but all you have to do is surrender. All you have to do is commit to your spiritual path, commit to the light, commit to being good, commit to, I'm not going to hurt another person. Okay, they might hurt me, but that's their bad. That's them clocking up bad karma for themselves. It's not my problem. I'm going to rise above this. I'm going to be the air dragon and I'm going to be fine. And also, I'm not going to be emotional. I do think, because that when I was thinking about this pencil today, for me, that's what the symbolism was here of this apple pencil. It was that, wow, there's no emotions here. It's just kind of thinking and technology and which is not bad, believe me. I like to be in robot mode sometimes because it's efficient and it works and it helps, you know. We can't be emotional all the time. That would be very difficult. So let's take a look at some quotes. Let's see what comes through. I'm really interested to see what the quotes are for this. But yeah, I mean, to be emotional is beautiful as well. Don't get me wrong. I love emotions. I think all this stuff is fascinating. And, you know, I love a good song. You can just cry to that song, or, you know, there's tears of all kinds. There's tears that are sad. There's tears of joy. There's, you know, there's all sorts of things. I love all of that. But sometimes we have to be, we have to dial back the emotion. And, you know, if you watch Anna Runkle, the crappy childhood fairy, she does talk about the fact that if you have CPTSD or any of that, the remedy is not always to feel, you know, feel it to heal it. That's a typical thing that we say in these circles, right? But that's not always the case. Sometimes you've got to just take time out from feeling and coast a bit, you know, that can be the right thing to do. Let's have a look here. So we've got this quote which says, normality is a paved road. It's comfortable to walk on, but no flowers grow there. Wow, that's interesting. Because, like, that's this apple pencil to me. The apple pencil is like a paved road. It's comfortable to walk on, but no flowers grow there. That's interesting. Yeah. So don't, I guess this quote is saying, don't be normal. Be you, you know. Yeah. I'm certainly not normal, you know. I quite like being my weird self. But yeah, okay, that's an interesting quote here. Again, there's something freeing in that quote. You know, be free. Roam on the ground where it's messy and there's flowers, and but it's beautiful, where life flourishes. I think life is going to flourish for you more next year. It's just if there's a little bit of blockages or something, that's all right. Let love come through and push that out of the way. This will go. I think and whatever is here, there'll be a joy and mastery of conquering it next year. That's for sure. Wow, this is good too. Smiling doesn't necessarily mean you're happy. Sometimes it just means you're strong. Yeah, that's true. Yes. Yep. And I think there is a real strength in this group that is going to develop, across 2024. Believe me, I've done my time in the Five of Swords and the Nine of Swords. Yeah, you bet. I know this. And it's like, and I welcome it if it has to come again, because my goodness, the strength you gain from this. Oh, yes, please. I love the strength that comes from challenge, you know, and there's always rest and reward and goodness that comes just after these things. You know, it's incredible to me how that stuff is built in to the curriculum. It really is. Guys, I'm wishing you all the best for 2024. Let me know how you get on in the comments below. By the way, I mean, this could be even just for the next little while or next, so it doesn't have to be the whole year or any of that. It could just be more recent. But yeah, let me know how you get on with this reading. And we are going to welcome group number two. I'm going to keep the camera rolling, even though we've got, so I went for 20 minutes just there. That is long. That I don't normally, but you know, I knew we were going to have a longer reading today because, well, I just thought we would, because we're looking at a year ahead. So I figure the readings are going to be a bit longer, and I've kind of got some more cards here too. So I'll keep the camera rolling, but it will switch off in a bit. Okay, let's put this here. How are you, group two? I hope you are well. I hope you're having a nice end to the year. Okay, group two. There we go. Welcome. So you have got this object. Now, when I was thinking about this pencil this morning, I really love this. It says doing my best on there. A little bit cheesy, but that's okay. And I couldn't find any that, you see, because I bought this kind of thing from a shop here called Tiger, and it was just like this. It didn't have that written on it, and you press the button and it's a pen, and it's a really good pen as well. It doesn't have blotches or ink blots or any of that. It's a really, it writes really beautifully. But what I like about this pencil thing is that it looks like a pencil, but then inside it's a pen. And what I like about that is, yes, it's a mask, right? But it's a mask where when you go deeper, you get something better. Because I think a pen is better than a pencil. So it's like it's a deceptive covering, but what's on the inside is even better. That's what I love about this pencil thing. So that's our little concept to begin with. Let's see what comes in the cards. It'll be interesting to see what comes here for group number two. And we are looking at the year ahead. We're looking at, I mean, if this applies to you more in terms of what's happening now, then that's how it applies. Whoops, I've dropped the pen. Oh no, how do I get it without? Okay, well, interesting. I've dropped the pen, but I'm picking it back up. We'll see if that factors in at any point. Might. Equally, it might not. All right, let's see what comes. Okay, I'll take one of those. We'll take a dragon card. We've got Year of the Dragon 2024. Okay, and one of these. Right. That came quite quickly. Let's take it. And one of these. Okay, let's see what comes in the cards. Ooh, transformation. Oh, I like this. Gosh, I don't even remember this card. when I flicked through, gosh, there's a lot in here. We've got a full moon. We've got these wonderful colors. My goodness. And it's kind of like, it is like a Russian doll type thing. That is fascinating, because I was saying that, like, what's in here, like, this is a mask. Okay, yeah, I was saying what's in here is a mask, but then you go deeper inside and there's a pen inside. So it's got the covering of a pencil, yet you go within and it's got something, because I perceive that a pen is more valuable than a pencil because its ink lasts for longer, right? So as you, the deeper you drill into this pencil, it's like you just keep uncovering, oh my God, there's something even more wonderful in here, you know? And then this is the image that we get, because look at this. It's like a Russian doll type shell. And then you go in and we've got this lovely lady, and then you go within her heart and there's this wonderful thing going on. It looks like two people or something, and then there's an archer here. Let's see if that can focus. There's all these wonderful magical things going on within her. So it's like there's a case, there's her, then there's more going on within her, and then probably within these people there's more going on. So that is incredible that that shows up here. Wow. All right, good. So maybe, I mean, maybe people are getting to know you more deeply. We've also got a 29 here, which is a master number. So it's like maybe people are going deeper within you, and like the deeper they go within you, they go, oh wow, and you know, he or she can do this, and oh my God, and wow, they've got that quality, and oh, they've got this, and oh, they've got that, and you know, it's that kind of thing where maybe people are getting to know you and they get more impressed or something, or because maybe you're quite humble on the outside or something like that. All right, let's see what's here. All right, so we've got Thor's red, black, and gold dragon protects you in times of change, a time of rapid transition and transformation. Relax, you are safe. Amazing, because this says transformation. Okay, right. This is going to be a transformative year for you guys. That's for sure. Or, you know, if you're just looking at this for a little while ahead, you're in a transformative period right now. See what this is, rock bottom. Okay, that is a good card to get, because the only way is up, right? So I like this. We've got a number one here as well. So I think you've hit rock bottom. It's time to go up now. See what this is. Wow, strength, that is beautiful. Let's focus that. Excellent. All right. Group number two. I think you're going to have some new experiences coming up. I think you've materialized this rock bottom card because you've hit it. Nothing's going to get any lower or any worse now if you are in challenging times. I think this strength card has come to say you are incredibly strong. And I think this is also a thing of like there's a very humble package here or something. Like there's so much within you. It's like the deeper you go into this, the deeper you go within yourself, the more gifts you're going to uncover. Strength is one of those gifts that you have, but there's even more there, okay? So it's about you, rather than focusing on the outside world, you devoting your time to developing what's within. So what gifts do you have? You know, do you have a great imagination? Do you speak really well? Are you creative? You know, what kind of things do you naturally love or like? And don't discount the simple things, because from really, really simple things, people build a world, people build a whole empire. You know, a lot of great businesses start just because somebody liked making one particular thing. You know, like somebody liked making hair scrunchies or something like that. And then like a whole entire business comes out of that, you know. And this is about, I feel like this is about you going within, nurturing what it is that you love, what you like, enjoying that energy and withdrawing your attention and focus from the outside world. Okay, because you can reclaim a lot of energy. Where do we lose our energy to? We lose it to, oh gosh, when I look at my various days, I lose so much energy to, you know, I don't know, watching the news about Omid Scobie's book or something. Yeah, I have been, you know, wasting time watching. But then some of that is a bit of downtime and you do need to relax and chill out. Like you can't always be studying, you know, your astrology books or whatever. So I do take a bit of time out, you know, but let's shuffle and see what this rock bottom is all about. I want to discover a little bit more. And what's the strength card about here? I also realized we've got the Vedic astrology deck there, which I didn't use for group one, but we might dig into that for you guys. Okay, so let's see what comes. We've got here, all right, the Six of Swords. Again, we've got another full moon. So you have, it's like you have completed something here, group number two, and it's like you're ready to move on. You are ready to move on from something, close out something, move on, because we can see this incredible full moon twice here. So you're leaving something behind, okay? So it could be that you're going to leave something here in 2023, and as you move into 2024, you've definitely got a new beginning. You've materialized that, okay? So that's great. Oh, fantastic. Ace of Swords, yes. Yes, this is wonderful. Really, really wonderful. Again, I think, we've got an ace here. It's a new beginning. And there is some level up. You're going to the next level up. You are mastering something. You know, it's like your sword is sharper and more powerful. So you're going to, yeah, you want to be careful about how you use that. Your sword is your mind. Okay. And that is the pen, the pencil. And I think it's good to be, I like the humble package thing, you know, because, yeah, that's how I see Sister Wendy Beckett. Sister Wendy Beckett, Carmelite nun, she was so sharp. Gosh, talk about the Ace of Swords. It's amazing that, yeah, I'm doing this reading around Christmas time because every Christmas I like to watch her DVDs. And she was such a humble package, but my goodness, she was an absolute powerhouse inside. You know, she's, yeah, like this pencil on the outside, pen on the inside. So yeah, there's something like that here for you. Let's get some more information from the Vedic astrology deck. Let's just draw one of these, see what comes. But there's something about, what are you leaving behind? Let's see, what are you leaving behind? And you've got protection. You're massively protected, group number two. Really, really, really protected. You're very, very strong, strongly protected. You're very protected. So don't be worried that something's gonna, you know, come for you or any of that. No, you're protected. If something does and you do have to do battle with it or something, you're strong. You can handle it. It's only coming in because, wow, yeah, Mars in the fourth. Okay, we'll take it and we'll take that one there. It's like if there's some challenge coming in, that means It's part of your learning, and it means you can use that challenge to level up or go higher or sort of integrate some more shadow or whatever it is. Like, yeah, so don't worry if there's something challenging. So we've got Mars in the fourth here. Difficult relationship with mum. Got here frustrated, cabin fever. This could also be difficult relationship at home or in the family home. Even with partner as well, fourth aspect onto partner. Got here cabin fever, owns properties, politically successful, tough childhood, moves house often, foreign settlement. Yeah, okay, so well, foreign settlement, that's indicated. Wow, moon in the first. That is interesting. Yeah, again, if afflicted, difficult relationship with mother. Interesting. So this could be a difficult relationship with mother, or challenge with mother, or something where you're taking your power back from childhood or how you were raised, or you're getting better at nurturing yourself as well. Okay, so that's another thing that we've got here. So these are all good things. Let's get another card. What other card do I want? I want one of these. Let's just see any more guidance for group number two. Wow, nice. Six of Pentacles. That is beautiful. Yeah, I knew there was something really positive. This is lovely. This is equal give and take. It's really interesting that we've got two women here. So this could be that you experience a healing in your relationship with your mother. There's some equal give and take here. It's like there's a healing. There could be a healing for your feminine side. Because we've got sort of argumentative energy here, and we've got feminine side here. We've got two women enjoying having tea with each other. So this could be a significant female in your life, or just a healing for your feminine side, and you getting a lot better at nurturing yourself so that you can share your many internal gifts with the world. Okay, that is very much what this is about. It's like you've got to share who you are. It's really interesting that Sister Wendy Beckett came up. Let's have a think about that. Why did she come in here? That's because she's such a humble package, and there are just so many gifts inside. There's like a universe inside of her. So that's you as well. And strength, I mean, she was really strong, you know. Really, really strong and really, really loving. So I think that's what's coming for your year ahead, group number two, that you are going to be more loving than you've ever been. You're going to be stronger than you've ever been. Your healing powers are going to go up. There's going to be more ability for you to bring all of these incredible gifts that you have. Look at all that you've got within you. Like, there's a world of stuff going on within her. And it's like, see, if a person just looked at the outer shell and goes, oh, that's just a, you know, doll, and they just move on. But the person who takes the time to open this up and go, oh my God, look at her. And then they talk to her and they see, wow, look what's in her heart. Wow, look what's in her imagination. Wow, look at this, look at that. Yeah, they're going to be rewarded. So the people who find you and who take the time to get to know you, they're going to be rewarded. And that's very Jupiterian in nature, actually, because... And the Jupiterian teacher likes it that way, which is really interesting. So the Venusian teacher gives it all on a platter. But the Jupiterian teacher is a little bit disguised and is like, well, the hardworking ones are going to find me, and they're going to get past the shell, and they're going to get all the good stuff. Something like that. Anyway, let's take a look and see what's in here. Group number two. I'm loving this. Look at that. And the progression of cards, it's like the more I shuffle, the more amazing cards come through as well. So it's like the deeper you go, group two, the deeper you go within yourself, the more jewels you're going to find. Same for people who meet you. I think this is that kind of thing that's going on here. And lucky are the people who are going to meet you, right? All right, let's take a look. So, oh, this is interesting. If someone is trying to bring you down, they are already beneath you. Yeah, this is a thing about quality and about like the people that you want are the hardworking ones who are going to make the effort. You know, most people will just walk past this and think, oh, it's just, you know, yeah, it's just a Russian doll with other Russian dolls in there. But it's not. It's a Russian doll with a beautiful woman with just all these incredible things inside of her. So that's you. And it's like, yeah, if someone is trying to bring you down, they are already beneath you. They're not worth your time. Those are the people who, yeah, wow. You're protected from them anyway. You've got all this protection here. Remember, we've materialized that. I think you're going to be protected from time wasters next year, which is good. All right, let's have a look at this. Ooh, yeah. Loneliness is the price you pay when you start to improve yourself. Yes, this is good. This is needed here because your worth is going up. Quality, everything is going up. Because at some point you'll be ready to like lose the pencil disguise and be the pen that you are, if you know what I mean. If we're looking at this pen as a metaphor, pen, pencil as a metaphor, you know, and you're doing your best. And know that everyone around you is doing their best as well. And that will help you to go easy on the people around you as well. Group number two, it's going to be a full, amazing year for you. I'm excited. This energy is just wonderful. You've got incredible energy here. And yeah, I mean, at times, you know, you might have to, there might be some times next year where it's right for you to be a bit of a loner, do your own thing because you're busy, you know, and you're creating incredible things. You're not going to have time for the time wasters, okay? And you will have time for those who are good quality and they know to look a bit deeper. They know not to just walk past this. Those are the ones that you want to entertain with your beautiful presence. All right, well, group number two, thank you so much for stopping by. And we are now going to welcome group number three. And I'm going to keep the camera rolling. And we're going to have we're at the 17-minute mark here. So at 24 minutes, it will cut out group number three, just so that you're aware. I'm going to put these back. Oh, that can go there. We'll put this one in there. Try to shuffle these. Put that on top. I will shuffle. Oh my goodness, group three. we just can't handle any more of this. Same cards keep coming up. What's going to happen today? I don't know. All right, group number three. Where are you, group number three? Group number three, or this beautiful pen, group three. Welcome, group three. Group three, welcome. You have chosen this pen, which is a really cool silver cross pen. This is my dad's pen, which I never use. I could use it to draw charts, but there's only a little bit of ink left in there. I can't even open it, gosh. Oh no, there we go. Yeah, it does open. Wow, there is some ink left in there. This probably comes from, I want to say like, I don't know, the 70s or 80s or something. I don't know, it's a long time ago. But yeah, this was my dad's pen. And this just reminds me of, well, lots of things. But my auntie, one time she said, about my dad. She said that, she said, your dad, he always had the nicest things. And she said, I don't know how he would do it, but he would always buy the nicest things. He had an eye for quality. He knew what to buy, and whatever he had, it was the best. And what else did she say? Yeah, he would buy the nicest things. And yeah, he would always have the best thing. And I think, well, yeah, that is true. He did have an eye for quality. And actually, the other thing of his that I have is it's at home in Sydney, and it's a tripod. And now that is really from the 60s, I think. Oh, and that's just the most incredible bit of engineering ever. It's all silver, and it's amazing. They don't make things like that anymore. That's a great object. I was using that when I was down there in Sydney for however long I was there. But yeah, I suppose, so this object contains past energy. See, this is in contrast to group number one, which had future sort of technology. This is past, and sentimentality and emotion and, you know, but something you want to keep forever. You know, you want to look after it. So let's see if any of all of these things come into your reading today, group number three. Let's hope I'm shuffling these cards properly. My goodness. Jeez, I've just been chatting while I was shuffling these. So, anyway, I don't know. Let's see. All right, group number three. What have you got going on? Oh, surrender. Yeah, well, that is a good idea. I tell you, I love a bit of surrender. I really do. Yeah, surrender's good. And it's the spiritual path. The entire spiritual path is made up of surrender. That's all you have to do, really. The work is letting go, because you already are. You already are everything you dream of becoming, you know? And I know these things intellectually. I know them as ideas, because every so often I sit with Lester Levinson's teachings and I read and I reread them. But, you know, practicing this stuff is another thing. But yeah, letting go. It's interesting. We've got a bit of holding on energy here too with the pen, like, you know, holding on to a bit of past here maybe. I mean, I'll never let this go. This is so precious to me. But I guess this is about knowing what to let go of, maybe, you know? What do you hold on to and what do you let go of? Oh, that's a big conversation right there. And this is something I've looked at in my own life. There are lots of things I have held on to. And it's pretty incredible what, like, the power of a compliment. Let's see if that story comes up here. Because there is one compliment I received a very long time ago, which I have held on to, and I continue to build on that one compliment. Let's see if any of that comes up. All right, let's see what's in the cards. We've got the Year of the Dragon, so we've got a dragon card. Ooh, nice. This is very bright. So it says here, golden orange dragon. Yes, creativity is orange. Be a peaceful warrior. Love it. Help those in need. Let's see if it's going to focus. Help those in need. Remember your magnificence. Yeah, absolutely. The other thing I love about this is, look at that. What's this? It's a book. Isn't that fascinating? That's great. You're creating something. You're writing something. You are busy. Okay. And we've got a lot of orangey brown Jupiter energy. You're expanding as well. Good. All right. Let's see what we've got here. Oh, I love this image. Wow. I don't remember this one. How cool. Gosh, I love the drama here. It's like, I don't know, the set of an opera or something. It's so cool. Oh, I like this image. That's great. Into the unknown. I love it. Yeah, I think whatever this creative journey is here, whatever you're creating, maybe you have no idea how you're going to do it, right? But there's an excitement here, okay? And I think it's going to be fun. So there's something to enjoy here. This is great. Okay. Oh, wow. Five of Cups. Wow. I wasn't expecting that. That's interesting. Okay, we're going to dig into that. Why is that here? Wow. I also like here, we've got some little hearts here. It's really interesting. We've got Five of Cups here, which is heartbreak energy. Okay, but it's interesting. If you look closely at this image, see if we can focus that. It's like that's a little heart there. That's a little heart. There are all these little hearts. Little bird. It's kind of wisteria type flowers as well. I love wisteria. That's such a wonderful fragrance. Okay, so we're going to see. We're going to shuffle for... Well, I mean, Five of Cups, we've got surrender. Gotta let go. You gotta let go. Let's see, what are you letting go of? All right, Five of Cups, heartbreak. We're gonna dig into that. We'll just get one for that. See what it is. It's interesting that compliment story hasn't come up yet. See if it does. It might not. So we get one for that, and we'll get one for surrender. All right. Wow, Queen of Cups. I like it. Really, really nice. Okay, good. This. Oh, fantastic. The World. Yeah. All right. Well, I love this energy. This is really great. I kind of think that, yeah, it's like maybe this is the last heartbreak that you'll ever go through. That's a big claim, right? But it's possible. Yeah. Why not? Why not? Whatever is the most recent heartbreak that you've had to go through, maybe that's the last. Maybe that's it. Because look at that, into the unknown. Oh, this is such nice energy here. She doesn't know where she's going. Okay, and that is scary. I get it. But you look at the scene where she is. Okay, we've got, and I was saying, and there's a rainbow behind her. There's these beautiful red curtains. There's wisteria all around. There are these hearts everywhere. There's this incredible building. Like into the unknown, it's like, it might seem scary, but it's like, I feel like you're done with heartbreak or life being like this all the time, because the World is completion. The Queen of Cups is so loving. There's just love all around her. So I think it's like we've kind of materialized your past and your future. Ooh. Okay, we've got cards dropping as well. Interesting. Kind of manifested, as I say, your past and your future all at the same time. It's really, really interesting. We've got, okay, orange dragon, orange second chakra, creativity, book, right? You're writing, maybe you're writing a piece of work, or you're creating a website, or you're creating a social media platform or videos or something. You're making something. Okay, so that's terrific. And that I feel like this into the unknown is linking into that as well. I think, but it's like it's you pursuing the fulfillment of your heart now, your heart space. You pursuing the fulfillment of your heart space. I feel like I want to shuffle more. The energy is so good here, but it's like, what do I take? Which deck? We'll just get one more of these and then we'll take a Vedic astrology deck card. But yeah, it's like you're in a beautiful place, but it's like you don't know you're in a beautiful place. Look at that. She's blindfolded. We've got this mixture of past, future. The future, you've closed out some cycle of heartbreak, and it's like you may never experience that level, that depth of heartbreak again. How about that? If not, you'll never experience heartbreak again, because we do want to be realistic here. But like, I don't know, your heart is so much stronger that maybe you can handle more love. Yeah, because we've got the Queen of Cups here. She's massively loving, you know, she's just completely abundant in love. Okay, so I just want to take a card of guidance. I don't know what it's in relation to, just what do we need to know? All right, take it. Let's see what comes. Whoa, Five of Wands, interesting. Competition. I do like it though. I've got an idea, but I want to get one more. Yep. Okay. Wow, death. Wow, again, it's being repeated. Yes, 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 yes. Okay. I'll tell you what I'm thinking. We'll just get one of these. How about just one? Because I feel like I know what that is. Oh. Oh, fantastic. Yeah. All right. Okay. Okay. Good. Again, within just the space of this reading, look at that. The end, death, the end of what? Competition. Okay. Beautiful. Right. So we've materialized here the end of, and this into the unknown. I just love it because this is linked in with your creativity. Basically, by following your creative path, by creating what you're creating, firstly, you might not even know how. You let's say you're writing a book and you're like, well, how do I write a book? I don't know how to write a book. I've never done it before. Keep doing it because that is going to take you somewhere wonderful. Okay, so don't worry about how. Just follow this creativity of yours. Follow it and it's going to take you somewhere amazing. Okay, so that is for sure. And then here we've got heartbreak card, right? But then what we manifested was Queen of Cups and the World, surrender. So all you have to do is let go. Let this go, because I drew that for this surrender card. So it's like you just let this any old heartbreak go and you're closing out heartbreak, okay, or any of that kind of thing. You're closing that out. You don't need to experience that again in this way ever again. Okay, you may experience a heartbreak in another way, but like in the way that you've just had heartbreak, you're not going to experience it like that ever again. That's closing out. Okay, you can be loving, right? And then we've got this, we've got the Five of Wands, which is a competition card, and then we drew death immediately after, so that this is the end of competition. Okay, so maybe before you were happy to be in a lineup of people and, oh, am I going to be chosen or something like that? No, forget that. That's not it anymore. You're this. Look at her. She's, and you're this. This is a queen card. Right? Again, you've got two queens here. The queen is Taurus moon, is moon in the second house. This is the exalted moon, okay? And you've got that here. This is the best moon card you can get, right? This is the queen. This is the moon in its best shape. So we've got Moon in the second house, has a large family, good childhood, money obtained through women, ups and downs in relationship with spouse, artistic, softly spoken, spends on pleasure. Yeah, so but basically we've got, look at that, Moon in the same house as the little star. It's exalted here. The best place of every single house, that's, if you could put the Moon anywhere, you'd put it there. You've drawn that. So you're, it's like 2024 is your year as a queen, embodying queen energy with nothing that's going to come in your way and try to drag you down or any of that. No, you've passed the tests kind of thing. You've done it. Yeah, that's what I'm seeing here. It's really cool. Really, really nice. And I think going forward, yeah, maybe I will bring up the compliment story. I've told one of you this in a reading actually some time ago, but it was a long time ago. I got a really nice compliment given to me by a friend at school, but it wasn't given to me. See, and this is why the compliment was so important to me, because she said this to somebody else. And it was in the last year of school, and basically I don't know, I did well in some exam or something, and this girl, I always used to admire her and I always used to really look up to her because she would always get the top marks. And she did like get, you know, really, really high top marks, but I did okay. But because of the marks I got, and because I did this interview thing, and anyway, I ended up getting a scholarship. And when she heard about that, she said to someone else, that girl is going places. And I always like hung on to that. Someone else told me she said that. She never ever said that to my face. But I used to hold her in the highest regard because she was super intelligent. Like she got way better marks than me, you know, and she was just super intelligent, super wise, super sensitive, super, all these just wonderful qualities. And yeah, I used to admire her a lot. And the fact that she said that to someone else, but she never said it to me as well, which I loved that she never said that to me. I loved that she never said that to me because it felt more authentic somehow. And I'm still trying to make that compliment a reality, if you know what I mean. I've held on to it. I've never let that go. So I think letting go is an interesting concept because you don't want to let go of everything all the time, you know, and that's this surrender here. It's like, but you do. I mean, ultimately we will. Our ultimate evolution is that we let go of absolutely everything. Our ultimate evolution is that we let go of ever needing to come here again. You know, I mean, that's the height of it. I don't know if I'm there yet. No, and I'm not, because there are still things that I want, isn't it? But yeah, I mean, that thing of what do you hold on to and what do you let go of? It's like this pen. I don't want to ever let go of this. Like, and well, maybe it will let go. Maybe, you know, I mean, we don't know the future. I mean, what if I lose everything in a fire or something? Or, you know, I mean, I doubt it. But like, you know, I mean, yeah, you can't take stuff with you. But that compliment, I've carried that for a long time. I've carried that since my teenage years, late teenage years. Yeah, I think I would have been 18 when I received that compliment through someone else. And I don't remember who told me. Isn't that interesting? I've forgotten now. How did I find out that she had said that? I remember her, and I remember her name, and I remember everything about her. I liked her so much. And we were never that great friends, interestingly. But yeah, I admired her and I liked her. But that is a compliment that I'm still trying to make come true, you know? Yeah, interesting. Wow, look at that. You are at your strongest when you are calm. Yeah, that's really true. And that's a Taurus moon right there. This is a calm moon. Okay, and if it doesn't have any Saturnian aspect and it doesn't have any Mars interference and it doesn't have any Rahu interference, that's probably one of the calmest moon minds you can get. So that's great. Great quote here, wow. But yeah, guys, look at what you let go of, but equally look at what you hold on to. And let me tell you, there's a great power in holding on as well. Okay, holding on to the right thing, you can build an empire on holding on to one compliment in your heart, you know? Wow, I like this. Judge no one. Whoops, not focusing. Judge no one, just improve yourself. Absolutely. It's like, do you know, it's like you're running in a race where there's only one person. Okay, so that's the other thing that these cards are saying. You are in a race of one now. There are no competitors. There's nobody else. There's just you. Just you. It's, look at that. We've got materialized the death of competition here. And we've got a queen card. It's like, yeah, that's it. There is no competition. There's just you. There's just you and God and your creativity. Surrender. That's it. There's no more. And it's like, yeah, the pain is gone now. And okay, if you are to encounter heartbreak in the future, it will be in a different way. It'll be a new dimension of heartbreak or this Five of Cups or whatever. But you've cleared something really big out, is what I'm seeing. Also note that we don't have any repeating cards from last time or any of that. Oh, but we do, yeah, there is this little one here that was there in group one. All right, well, let's take another card for that. Let's just see now with the new awareness of what's here. Ooh, I can't unsee it. We'll take it. We'll take one more. Oh, the greed. We'll take them all. It's the last reading that I'm going to do. Yikes. Don't mind me. Ugh. That's just my necklace tapping the tripod. Okay. I can't unsee that one. So we're going to take that one. I'll put the other one and we look at it. There we go. So this popped out, Father, which is kind of interesting because that is my dad's pen. So that's pretty cool. But there could be, I don't know, something connected there with Father, which is pretty interesting. We've got dark blue here. We've got Saturn. And we'll see what these two are about. Oh, how wonderful. Embrace and journey. These are lovely. Yeah. I think you just need to embrace your journey, your unique journey that you're on, which is just about you and no one else. And there is no competition because you're too unique. There's no one else that's like you. So embrace your uniqueness, group number three, and judge no one and just improve yourself. I think these are the words that we're going to finish on here today. Oh, let's focus there. Come on, focus. Yeah. Just improve yourself. Just run your own race, your race of one, group number three. Well, let me know how you get on in the comments below. I realize it's probably hard to judge this one because, you know, it is kind of for next year. But I mean, if this feels good, yeah, let me know in the comments below. Any comment is wonderful. I love hearing from you guys. And I'm wishing you all the best for 2024. I will be heading off to Sydney, Australia. And while I'm down there, I'm not going to have all these various card decks. I will have a couple of card decks with me and we might do a little random pick a card here and there. But just stay tuned on the channel. You'll see where I am and where I end up and what I end up doing. I don't even know myself. I've got some ideas, but yeah, I'm looking forward to a bit of warmer weather actually. All right, well, take care, everyone. And I look forward to seeing you next time.